Today, I'm going to continue my series on Fibonacci heaps and discuss the extract min method. If you haven't seen the other videos in the playlist, I recommend starting with those as they lay the groundwork for this video. As a quick review, a Fibonacci heap is a data structure that implements a mergeable heap, which supports five methods: make heap, insert, minimum, extract min, and union. Fibonacci heaps also support decrease key and delete. In this video, we're going to unpack the extract min method. In the last video, we learned that the insert method is lazy. We insert a node into the root list and update the minimum node if applicable. Extract min does the heavy lifting and consolidates min heap ordered trees. Let's use the following Fibonacci heap as our example. As a reminder, Fibonacci heaps have a pointer to the minimum node and to the root list. The root list is denoted by the dotted line. We will extract the minimum node, which is 2. Here's the code for extract min. I'll cover this in steps and show changes to the heap along the way. We first store a pointer to the minimum node, which we'll call z. We check if z is not none. If it is, the heap is empty and we have nothing to do. We then check if z has children. If it doesn't, we can skip some steps. If it does have children, we need to move them into the root list before we extract the minimum node. Let's pause there and I'll show what these lines of code do to our Fibonacci heap. I'll take just that code block and show it on the bottom of the screen. Our first step is to set z equal to the minimum node. We see that z is not none, and also that z.child is not none, as z has 3 children. Therefore, we need to insert z's children into the root list. I'll color z's children blue, and we're going to move them into the root list. Our code specifies that the children are added at the end of the root list. Here is the result. Back to the code. We're now on this line. It's time to remove z from the root list. I'll display the remove from root list method at the bottom. We first check if root list is pointing to z. It's not, so we don't need to update the root list pointer. We then update z.left and z.right to point to each other, moving z out of the root list. The min still points to z, which will update momentarily. Back to our code, we're on this line. If z is equal to z.right, we know that z was the only node in the Fibonacci heap, and we set min and root list to none. This was not the case in our heap, so we update min to be z.right for now, and we call another method, consolidate. Consolidate reduces the number of min heap ordered trees in our Fibonacci heap and sets the true minimum pointer. I'll put the code for consolidate to the right. The goal of consolidate is for each node in the root list to have a distinct degree value. If you remember from the first video, the degree is the number of children in the node's child list. I won't walk through this code line by line, but in summary, it finds 2 nodes in the root list with the same degree, and it makes the node with the larger key a child of the node with the smaller key. It does this until each node has a distinct degree value. Back to our Fibonacci heap after removing z from the root list. Note that we temporarily set the min to z's right, which was 16. This, of course, is incorrect, but the consolidate method will set the true min value. I'll put each root list node's degree in yellow above the node. Again, this is the number of children in the node's child list, and our goal is for these values to be distinct. I'll clear some real estate, and we'll step through the consolidate process. We'll use the array shown at the top to help us with consolidation. Each index of the array will contain a pointer to a node with the same degree. In other words, index 0 will point to a node with the degree of 0. Let's iterate through the root list, and I'll show you what I mean. We start with 5, which has a degree of 0. We add 5 to our array. Next, we move to 16, which has a degree of 1. Now to 9, with a degree of 2. We reach node 12, which has a degree of 1. But you can see the array already has a node at index 1. This means it's time to combine min heap ordered trees. Because 16 is greater than 12, 16 becomes a child of 12. We update the degree of 12 to 2 and clear the node 16 from the array at index 1. We're still on node 12, which now is a degree of 2. If we look at the array, we already have a node with degree 2, node 9. 12 is larger than 9, so we make 12 a child of 9. We update the degree of 9 to 3. Notice the node 9 also moves spots in our array. We move to node 38, which has a degree of 0. There is a conflict with node 5, and we make node 38 a child of 5, increasing the degree of 5 to 1. Lastly, we move to 19, and again make it a child of 5. We're left with 2 nodes in the root list, each with a unique degree. We set the min pointer to 5, since it's less than 9. And we still have our pointer to z, which is what is returned by the extract min method. Coming back to our code, the final step is to remove 1 from the number of nodes in the Fibonacci heap. Lastly, we return z. I'm going to skip discussion on runtime of extract min, but I will make another video on it if there's interest. In the intro video, we learn that the amortized runtime of extract min is big O of log n. The code shown in this video is linked in the description. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.